Hello, HGTC students. Today we are going to review the content tool in your D2L. The content tool is where you'll find most of your course material needed in the class. This may include syllabus, lecture notes, readings, PowerPoint presentations, study notes, website links, and more. To access your content tool, you'll first need to log into your D2L account. If you need assistance with this, please contact the Student Information Center, WaveNet Central, or view our video on how to log into WaveNet to access your D2L course. To access the content tool, you'll first need to log into D2L. You'll find your D2L homepage here. We'll then have to enter the actual course. You can enter the course by clicking on the course name under the My Course widget, or by selecting a course up here. Let's go ahead and click on our course here. Once you're located on the course homepage, you'll have many different options to review here. Today we're going to focus on the content tool found at the very top of the page. Let's go ahead and click on content. After you clicked on the content tool, you'll be able to view all the course content for that particular class. When accessing this tool, you'll see a table of contents with all the items used throughout your course. You may read these items as many times as you'd like throughout the duration of the course. The document may be separated into groups are shown all together as one depending on the professor's preference. For example, this professor has grouped the content by guidelines, forms, agenda, and minutes. Some professors may group the items by chapters or units. Depending on the professor's preference is what you'll find here. All the content will be organized into the separate groups. You will also be able to see what documents you've already reviewed and what documents you still need to review by the check marks found on the right-hand side. Here we can see a gray bullet. It indicates that these items have not been read yet. If we hover the mouse over the gray bullet, you can see the task is to view this topic. After we've already reviewed the topic, we will receive a check mark that indicates that we have viewed this topic. Now we're going to take a look at what it looks like when a document is open in the content tool. To open and view any of the documents, you simply click on the link shown in blue here. We're going to go ahead and click on one of these to open up and view the document. Once the document is done loading, you'll have many different options of viewing the document, downloading the document, or printing the document. Here we can see at the top the title of the document, as well as a breadcrumb trail to see what table of content group we're located in. Now we'll also have other options here on the right-hand side of the screen. The first one we'll talk about are the arrows here. You can simply switch between documents, going through all the documents of the course content. Right now we're viewing a document on a workshop. If I click this next arrow here, we can see the next document is a PowerPoint for study skills. And this is all in Unit 1 still. Now if I go to the next document by clicking the next arrow, we can see we have now moved on to Unit 2, where there are assignments and a test. So we can see here, we just went through Unit 1 by clicking on the last two assignments, and it moved us straight to Unit 2. Now let's go back in and view the document one more time and look at a couple other different tools. Right next to the navigation arrows, you'll see a button to view content in a new window. This could be useful when you need to review multiple documents at once. If I click on this icon, I see that it pops up in a new window. Here I can have other options. I can download the document here by clicking download. We can make it full screen. We can zoom in or zoom out, and we can sort by pages. Going to page 1 to 3 and back to 1. Reasons for downloading the document: you can either save it onto a flash drive or maybe your desktop, or you may want to download the document in order to print it. I'm going to go ahead and click cancel here. So we have the document open here. It could become very useful if you needed to have two documents open at once. So if we go to the next arrow and we wanted to maybe review our PowerPoint with our workshop material, we would click here and again use that same icon to open the content in a new window. Here, if we make it smaller size, we can again use our zoom in and zoom out buttons to view the screen easily. And now we should have two of the documents open at once. If you need to zoom out or zoom in to review the document easier, you can use that option. So that's a nifty tool that you can use when studying or preparing for your course. We're going to go ahead and exit both of these. So we just reviewed these two. Now let's go back to our original document here. We can see here we have our bookmark that is highlighted red. That means that right now we have this particular document bookmarked. We'll talk a little bit about that in our video of how to bookmark an item and why that's important. We can bookmark it here or unbookmark it here, whatever we prefer. Moving down to the bottom of the page, again you'll see the same items that we saw before as far as downloading the document, making it full screen, previewing it through different pages, or zooming in and zooming out. You can also download the document from here. Either way will work the same. Next, we are going to go back to the table of contents and review some other things found on our content tool. By going back to the table of contents, I simply click on the table of contents icon in the breadcrumb trail. Here you can see we're back on our table of contents. Some things I wanted to point out: we do have a status bar of tasks that you've completed and uncompleted. So again, that shows you the check marks there. We also have an option for you to search for topics. For example, if I'm trying to find something in a certain chapter or a certain unit, I can search for that document by simply typing in a keyword, clicking search here, and it pulls up all the related items. You also have an option for upcoming events such as quizzes or tests that your professor may or may not post. Going back to the table of contents, those are all the options that you'll need to use in the content tool to become successful in your D2L course. If you have any questions or need assistance with using any of these tools, please visit the Student Information Center, WaveNet Central, or give us a call at 843-349-5182. Thank you.